Shalom chaverim and welcome to Rega Be'ivrit. This is Rabbi Shapiro. We're starting the book of Vayikra. The book of Vayikra is a very unique book because in the fourth chapter we see the word Mashiach mentioned for the very first time. The word Mashiach in Hebrew comes from the title Mashach, Mem Shin Chet. Okay, interestingly enough, the word mashach means to anoint or pour, like to pour oil on a person. And who is the one who called Kohen Mashiach? It's Aaron. Now the name Mashiach, interesting enough, mentioned in the Sanhedrin 98, Sanhedrin 98b, in context to four names of the Mashiach, not one name. So we see that according to four rabbis, the name it is called there is called Mem for Menachem. Mem for Menachem, the comforted. Shin for Shiloh from Genesis 49. Yud for Inon from Psalm 72 because he endured before the sun. And Chet for Hezekiah. Hezekiah was one of the people they said in Mashiach. Hanania, which means God has pardoned us. And then the rabbi said, no, his name is none of those. He's called the leper scholar. He resembles a leper. So why did the rabbi say that he will recall all those names after the name of the rabbis? Because they explained that's not going to be his physical names. It will represent his attributes. He will be the comforter. He will be the one who will bring a gift for him. He will be one who endure before the sun, and he will be the one who give us a paradigm. Now look with me quickly in the book of Leviticus, chapter 4, verse 3, and it says there, and I quote, וידבר אדוני אל משה לאמור, and the Lord spoke to Moses to say, verse 2, דבר אל בני ישראל, speak to the children of Israel, לאמור, כי נפש כי תחטא בשגגה. What's the meaning of the word שגגה? שגגה mean if a soul sin unintentionally, an accident, a mistake. And here God says in the rest of the chapter, if somebody sin unmistakably, here's what they need to do. But you know what I want you to pay attention. Verse 3. If a Kohen HaMashiach yechete, if the high priest sins. Okay, here's an interesting thing. Kohen Mashiach. It's two words. The high priest, anointed. It's appeared like Aaron sinned. But pay attention. It says, Le'ashmat Ha'am. The word there, Le, when you see before the word, Le, the lamed with dagesh, it's been to the sins of the people. It's interesting because it says le'ashmatan, it says if Aaron sin according to the sins of the people. Interesting. The Torah suggesting that it was not Aaron who sinned, it is Aaron who took upon himself the sin of the people, because it's have the word le. The delay means that Aaron took upon himself the sin of the people and he became a sinner. In the book of Corinthians, it says that Messiah became sin. In the book of Ezekiel, it says that he take upon himself and he make an atonement. Does that mean that the Mashiach actually sinned? Does that mean that the Mashiach actually committed those transgressions? The Torah itself says no, and Chazal went and explained that it is the Mashiach who is the representation of the nation. He is one in the same with the nation. Yeshua done exactly the same thing. Le'ashmat Ha'am mean that he took upon himself the sin of the people, and the letter Lamed with a Dagesh mean towards the sin of the people. It's counted as Aaron's sin. Yeshua has sinned, but his sin was not his sin. He became sin. He took upon himself the sins of the people. And that is the job of the Kohen Mashiach. And that's why the rabbi says his last name, the scholar leper. He is a leprosy. He took upon himself our leprosy, is the ultimate name of the Mashiach. Shalom chaverim velitraot.